Hey folks, Free Play Frank. Today I got a video for you guys of a one-of-a-kind machine, the Mr. Hydraulics Crane. And then later I'm going to play an awesome Boston song from their debut album, Peace of Mind. Now my shout-out tonight goes to Garage 54, my Russian connection. Now these guys, basically what they do is they do experiments with cars and engines and stuff, and like really bizarre and outrageous and hilarious stuff. And they're in Russia, so they use Russian cars, usually Ladas. And on one that they took a Lada and they put four engines in it. One engine right in front of the other, and the engine stuck out the front of the car so far they had to put another set of axles at the front to hold the front of the car up. And then there was one where they took the wheels off the car and they replaced them with round saw blades, and they drove around on the ice with saw blades for wheels. So you guys gotta check these guys out. These guys are hilarious, and they're skilled mechanics and fabricators as well. And they've got the classic Russian voiceover or English voiceover, whatever you call it. But you can still hear them speak Russian. Anyways, super cool channel. All right, let's get at her. Alright, today we're going to be talking about my homemade hydraulic truck crane. Now, I call this Mr. Hydraulics because I'm not very creative. If I was creative, I'd give it a more fancy name, but it started out life as a 1978 F-250. And I put, the rear end is out of a 1965 Ford school bus. And then the Hiab is, I believe it's a Hiab Foco, which was made in Finland, I think. Before they became Hiab, they were Foco, and then I think Hiab probably bought out Foco. Then it was called Hiab Foco. Anyways, this was a regular truck crane that runs off of a PTO, but I mounted it on here running off of its own engine. The reason I built this thing was because I used to have a junkyard and I needed ways to load my stuff in and out of the truck and pull engines out and stuff like that. So what I ended up doing was I took the base of the crane and I mounted it parallel to the frame. Like this used to be the hydraulic tank as well, but I did away with the hydraulic tank there and I added this hydraulic tank. And I had a machinist friend help me rebuild the rotator, because that's the reason why this crane was being sold for $200 at an auction, because the rotator was shot. And I mounted the stabilizers on the back so that they push down like this. And then this unit here in the middle of the boom is off of a concrete pump truck. It's a six-way, I forget what they call it, rotating manifold, I believe. So you run six hoses in, and it has six hoses that come out of the center, and the hoses go up the middle of the boom to run the Hiab. So let me get around here, walking around all the obstacle course. Okay, so what I did was I mounted a Chevette motor. Used the Chevette motor because it only had 60,000 miles on it. It ran really good. And Chevette motors were originally designed to be used in forklifts, I was told. Not sure if that's true or not. But you can run it from up here. The motor runs and starts from up here. It's got its own alternator, its own charging system. Oops, I've got two hydraulic pumps. One runs directly off of the crankshaft. And that one runs the boom. And it's been so long now I can't remember what each one runs. And the other one runs the swing and probably the grapple. I have a grapple for this too. It's not on it right now. And then we have each pump runs its own valve. You see I got a couple blown hoses. That's what the plastic's to try to keep the water out of the system. But this one here runs off the direct
and the crankshaft pump that runs the boom and the other hydraulics on the main lift part. And got a greasing valve under here. Yeah, I know it's really, really greasing. And this runs the swing. Another thing I did with this was I mounted a hydraulic pump that runs a four-wheel drive transfer case with a chain drive that's on the drive shaft, so that I can sit up on the crane and I can move the machine from up there. There's a pedal, and it push it one way, you go forward, you push the back of the pedal, you go reverse. Unfortunately, that didn't work so well because I think this pump's worn out. Like, it'll work when there's no load on it. If you jack up one wheel, it'll spin fine, but as soon as you try to drive the truck, it just sits there and won't move. So, but I ended up, when I was using it, I just used the boom to push it ahead. And here's the bottom of the boom. It just has a cable with two hooks right now. And I added this hydraulic cylinder onto the boom, like the small hydraulic cylinder. You can see it in the middle of the boom there, and that's to extend the stick farther out. I can reach about 16 feet with this. The hydraulics were all excellent condition. The only problem it had was the control valve leaks, and that motor that moves it from up here doesn't work properly. But anyways, let's see what it looks like from here. Oh, and to do the swing, what I did for the swing was, you see this big double chain here. This double sprocket is affixed permanently to the base of the machine. And then up on the swing house here, I've got a hydraulic motor that runs an old winch, worm drive off of an old winch. And it turns that, so it'll turn 360 degrees. That works really well. See what this part of the boom looks like. And I made the controls so it's the same as cat controls on an excavator, the same pattern as cat controls, if you know what that is. And then we have these other two levers here. One is been so long now I can't remember what these are for. One is for steering, because I also have a hydraulic ram attached to the steering on the front of the truck, so I can steer it from up here as well. And the other one, I believe, is either to open and close the grapple, or maybe for the stabilizers, probably for the stabilizer. Yeah, that's what it would be for, because the open and close the grapple would be on the same as the bucket movement for the cat control. So, I don't know if I want to try and climb up there, but he'll try and walk around here again, give you a better shot of the motor. Okay, well, here's the motor. I used a radiator off of a 68 Ford pickup truck. And it's running on propane. I made my own adapter. It's a forklift propane mixer. I made my own adapter. I made my own. You can see all I did to mount that pump as I took apart the old catalytic converter, or not catalytic, torque converter that came on the automatic transmission that came with this Chevette, and I cut it in half on the lathe and put a shaft, and you can see the shaft run down through the middle there through that pillow block to turn the main drive of the pump. And I've got another space for another pulley. It needs it because one belt isn't enough. The belt just slips as soon as you get a load on that. So basically I had this at my junkyard for probably only, it took probably 2.5 years to build this rig, and I don't think I used it more than 2 months before I closed that business down. See the top of the exhaust pipe? So it did work. It worked quite well, actually. And this is the propane tank that runs the carrier motor. Here's a shot of the inside. See, I got some unwelcome tenants living in the roof there, unfortunately. But this truck used to be a masonry truck, so it was wore out. The rear suspension was completely shot, so I had no problem getting rid of the box on the rear end and putting that bus rear end under it. I made my own brackets for the mirrors. Lots of junk piled on it. heavy-duty winch bumper to help hold the front down, and yeah, it needs it. When you put it in low gear and try and move with that crane on there, it pops wheelies. So it needs that weight on there. Anyways, it's, whoops, there she be. I hope to get this going here. I'm not sure when, but I plan on building a firewood processor. I figure this would be a good rig to load the logs on and off. Okay, so this lever here changes from upper drive to lower drive. And it's been so long since I've used this, so I can't remember which way is which, but I think back would be lower drive to move the machine with the truck engine. And if you pull, it's all stuck now, but if you pull it ahead, it comes about this far ahead, then that disengages the lower drive and engages a hydraulic motor that turns that big sprocket. And see the green lever there going across with the dog clutch? What that does is it disengages the transfer case, so it goes into two wheel, because I mounted the transfer case so that it's not driving with the input shaft, it's driving with one of the output shafts. Like the rear output shaft is being driven by the truck motor. So the front, the shaft that would have driven the front axle is driving the rear axle. So by doing that, I can disengage the transfer case and put it into four-wheel drive and allow it to be turned with a hydraulic motor, which turns that big sprocket. And the controls, well, there's the hydraulic motor there, you can see it there. And the controls, one of the pedals, you push the pedal down to go forward and step on the back of the pedal with your heel to go reverse. And that works quite well, but like I said on the earlier video, the hydraulic motor is worn out. So you gotta jack one wheel up and then it'll turn, but as soon as you let it down, it won't move. It'll just sit there and try and spin. All right, we're underneath the front of the crane truck now. I wanna show you how I did this steering here. Now, sorry about the bad lighting, guys, again, but see, I have a hydraulic cylinder that's attached to the frame over on that side. And you can see I took a piece of a old drag link, welded it onto the drag link for the truck. So this moves the drag link back and forth, and again it's connected up to the top platform on the crane so that you can move a lever back and forth and steer the truck. Now I'll show you how the back part of it works here. You can see these two lines here, they go, these are lines that go, one of them connects to the big green lever. What it does is there is a hydraulic valve here that I can put it in neutral so that it bypasses and allows the cylinder to move freely back and forth without building up pressure on either side. It releases the connection between the two hydraulic circuits. And there's also, that's connected to that long green lever so that when I put it in upper drive, it closes that valve and it allows the hydraulic pressure to control that cylinder. And when I put it in lower drive, it opens up that valve so that you can steer it with the steering wheel without building up pressure. Okay, so let's go up on top. Walk across here, all a mess. Careful of the barbed wire. I'll show you the controls. This is filthy, it's been sitting here for 10 years and I haven't tried to clean it or anything or do anything with this. So anyway, so I got this little tin cover here that covers the dash that I made for it. And see, it's got a tack and it's got three gauges there, oil pressure, temp, and battery. And the push button switch is the starter, and the toggle switch is ignition on and off. And I've also got provisions to put lights on here, but I never did install them. And this is an old office chair, a really old office chair, probably from the 40s or something, that I found in a yard cleanup. It used to be mint, but the top of the seat pad has come off of it now. So, okay, let me try and I want to show you guys how the controls work on this thing. not too keen about sitting on this filthy seat, but it's not like my shorts are clean anyways. Okay, so like I said, it has cat controls. So we got the two big levers here, and it's the same pattern to operate the boom as a caterpillar control excavator. And then one of these levers controls the steering, and the other one controls the rear stabilizers. And then the two pedals down there, one of them controls the travel, and the other one, I can't remember what the other one controls. It's been 14, 15 years since I've used this. And you see the odd design of this boom, like it has a, there's the pivot point for the main hydraulic lift cylinder. And then it has this weird thing here where it has this pivot point here, and then there's another pivot point there. So I'm not really sure what the theory behind that was. I think this crane was probably designed originally to install telephone poles, but it's a really, really early version of a high-ab style crane. I've never ever seen another one like it, and nobody I know ever has either, so we can't really determine, but I figure it's probably from the 50s, maybe early 60s at the newest. A big tree branch fell on my hood. I used to be able to open this. I don't know if I can open it now, but I'll try. Nope, stuck shut. But anyways, you guys know what a Chevette motor looks like. I don't have to show you that part. But yeah, she's an interesting machine, and I had fun running it, but I didn't run it for very long, unfortunately. I wish I could have gotten to use the maximum of its potential before it ended up getting stored and forgotten about, but well, that's life. Anyways, this is a cool project. A goat stood on the roof to eat this maple tree, and they broke off all the lenses off of the clearance lights. And for a seat, I put a bucket seat out of a Datsun 300ZX. It was a nice leather bucket seat. Oh. Anyways, there she is. Like I say, I plan on doing videos in the future and where I do some work on this machine and try and get it up and running.
To have my peace of mind. Thanks guys for joining me, and we'll see you all next week. Take care.